So once tunnelling starts here, the Gabba site is critical for tunnelling works. It's basically the epicentre. Everything is basically focused on the Gabba.
Yeah, we've been preparing for over 2 and a bit years now. So this started, it's been a bit of a journey. When we first got the Woolloongabba site over 2.5 years ago, and the enabling works team demolished the GoPrint site.
What we're building is an underground train station. It'll be sitting in a large 4-hectare area. There'll be a new town centre for Woolloongabba.
This site has a really long history, industrial uses, other industries that were here, digging down multiple layers of the soil, and the history that got uncovered as part of that was some expected, some unexpected.
The tunnel itself is it's air. If you're not deep enough, it'll almost be like a soft drink bottle, it'll want to pop out. So you've actually got to be deep enough with enough rock cover so that it doesn't want to float. Where we've put the alignment under the river, we know that we've got about 7 or 8 metres of rock cover, which is about what we need to be safely tunnelling underneath the river.
TBM tends to get the majority of the focus, and rightly so, because it's generally the critical path for the project. But there is so much supporting activity that's come together to make that happen and support that. Albert Street, that has to be ready to receive the TBM. So there's a significant amount of focus on making sure that the tunnelling's going well, the logistics are supporting the work that needs to be happening at Albert Street, so that everything can be delivered on time, so that when the TBM is knocking at the door of Albert Street, we're there to let it through.
TBM's a large factory. You have to feed it segments, and you have to take away the waste, which is the spoil. There's a real balancing act there. You can't go too fast, otherwise you're generating too much spoil. And if you're not keeping the segments up, that's actually going to slow your production.
We'll be moving to having day shift and night shift. 130 of these segments per day. And in total, there are more than 4,000 drinks to be made for this project.
You know, we're looking for quite a high degree of accuracy in their ability to drive to a design centre line. But the challenge is you can't get a GPS site from 30 metres below the Brisbane River or under Albert Street. We've been busily trying to move towards that tunnelling start date, and there hasn't been a relaxation in that 2 years.
I'm Megan Wood, Southern Area Manager for the TSD project.
Greg Reichman, TSD Delivery Manager.
I'm Megan Safari, and I'm the Quality Systems Engineer here.
Tai Leong, Area Engineering Manager for Woolloongabba and Tunnels.
Jeremy Kruger, I'm the Project Director for the Tunnel and Stations Package on Cross River R.